issues with, and this is the problem, I believe. I believe that it's the drive. I don't know if you can see it right there. The hard drive is what I believe the problem is. And I also noticed that there's just one drive there for RAM. And I've already found one issue that I resolved, and that concerns the CMOS battery. I went in and I reset the little plastic thing down there to where freaking it resets that, and I did the other one for the password too. I pulled out the battery here and I replaced it with an old battery that went to the same Dell system in it, and it took care of a problem concerning the boot system wanting to boot up through the internet instead of through the computer. I'm gonna plug in the system now, and I'm gonna show you guys what I'm talking about. But let me get some shots of it. I see that right there is for the internet, and it kicks in automatically. And here's the process that takes place. This is what happens on my system whenever it gets started. No boot device detected is what it is, but this is another setup system that's problem. It says updating ESCD success. Then Broadcam Undi PXE 2.1 build 082 version 103. And then copyright C 2000 to 2002 Broadcam Corporation. Client Mac ADDR 00OB DB 266C D9 GUID 445 4C 5600 104C 8046 04F573231 and then DHCP, and then it has the little emblem that's turning. To me, it looks like it's got a MAC address hooked to it, and it's trying to pick up a signal to where it could boot up through the internet through that MAC signal. And Broadcom Corporation. And then it says PXE MOF exiting Broadcom PXE ROM. No boot device detected. Insert system disk. Press F1 to continue or press F2 to set up menu. Now, I know a lot of people have a reason for that, but I've already discovered it. And the reason for it is inside of your CMOS battery. Like I said, this is the old one, and I replaced that with a different CMOS out of a different Dell altogether, and it took care of that internet problem where it was booting up with the internet. So for me, I think that problem's solved. That's what that part is. So I can move on to the next. I still have more issues with it, so let me get back to it. Alright, so now I've replaced that CMOS battery with a different CMOS battery that came out of an older model Dell, just like this one. It's a Dell. And I am going to plug it in after I wait. 5 minutes, and each time I touched the side so that I could take the magnetism out of my hands when I touched the motherboard and stuff. I know a lot of people say that you need to get those bracelets, and I just see that as a gimmick for getting money, because I know for a fact that all you have to do is touch the side of the computer with both of your hands and it demagnetizes your hands. But with all that said, I'm going to move on to what I was talking about. Now that I have that in, I'm going to plug in the computer again. And I'm going to start it up, and you'll see that that message is gone. Okay. And another thing, if you're having a hard time getting to this, you're okay, then my best suggestion to you, even if you're not replacing a battery or anything in there, is unplug your computer and it'll automatically take you to the screen without it going by real fast. And you can have time to look at it and do what you need to do. But the writing on here is Phoenix Award Bias V600PG and Energy Star Ally, copyright C 1984 to 2001, Phoenix Technology LTD. And the BIOS is A02. The main processor is an Intel Pentium R4, 2.2 gigahertz, 100 by 22.0. Memory testing is 128 millibytes, and it's okay. Now, the RAM on here is only 138 millibytes, so I'm guessing that's where most of that's coming from. The primary master, there's none. The primary slave, Mextor, 2FO040L0. VAM51JJ0, and the secondary master is Light On Elgin 486S, 48 by or X, and max is YDS6. Secondary slave is HL/DT/STGCE8481B. C102. Now, with this, the CMOS checksum error defaults loaded, and it gives you the option of press F1 to continue, F2 to set up, F12 for boot menu, and F10 for utility mode. Right now, I'm just going to run it through and let you guys see it instead of going to the setups. This is the difference between the first time and the second time. And you'll see what I'm talking about. Well, actually, it did it that time. See, that's with the internet on. And it'll show the error message here. So, I guess I was wrong. It actually is probably the hard drive or the RAM. I'm guessing it's the hard drive. The RAM only has one stick, or one memory chip too, by the way. So I'm gonna replace that one with two new ones, and there it is. And what I'm gonna do next is go ahead and turn this off, and I'm going to replace that chip with two memory chips and see what happens after that. and if that helps, then fine. If it doesn't, then I'm going to go ahead and replace the external or internal hard drive. I'll be right back. Okay, so right here I pulled the RAM out, and this is the only one that they had here. I can read it to you and tell you what it says. It is BVDDT. The writing, I'm getting older, so it's kind of old. Or kind of hard to read, but it's 664AG2658 PC2100U253380, M010URV is the second line for the MY. It is underneath the first line at the beginning, and then it has the M010URU, I believe. And then it goes to 200320, and then on the third line it is 128 MB 00R266 Hz D25. Now this is the old one. I'm gonna pull this one out and I'm gonna replace it with newer ones. And I'm gonna set that up here. Trying not to touch it as much as possible. But these are the new ones. And it's the same basic kind. I'm not gonna show you guys me installing it in here. I ended up pulling it from there. And there was, like I said, there was only one in there, so. And I'm not for sure if these are the same make, but I'll go ahead and read it, I guess. No, but